In this session, we are going to discuss security, system security. And this security can be divided into mainly two aspects. One is your authentication and another one is your authorization. Authentication and authorization. So these are two main aspects of the security. Authentication actually, it verifies the user's identity. And Wiz performs authentication by its knowledge. That means, in case of authentication, at first I shall have to identify the respective user, whether the user is should be allowed to access some system resource or not. And this sort of authentication can be done by the known knowledge, that is the knowledge between the user's some detailing and the OS knowledge. So that will be some communication. So it might be done through some, say, fingerprint recognition, ear pattern recognition, tongue print recognition, voice recognition, retina recognition. It can be also done by passwords or by some other means. So in this way, one user must be validated, whether that user is authenticated to access some resource of the system or not. So that's why we have written that OS performs authentication by knowledge. And what about the authorization? User has got authenticated, so he or she has got an entry to access the system resource. But what are the resources he or she can access? And what are the operations he or she can carry out on those resources? So authorization involves verifying user's right to access a resource in a specific manner. That means whether he or she can perform the read operation or write operation or update operation, what it can do, what it should not do. So that will be depicted in the authorization aspect. And there are four levels of security measures. One is your physical, next one is human, network, and then OS. So in case of physical means, you are giving a physical security to the system. You might be having some armed forces and they are giving that security to the system. So that means whatever you are doing, you are just making that one physically available. So by the armed security agencies or some other means. In case of human security, that means each and every user should be screened. That means what he is doing or what he is not doing. So that sort of level of security should be there. So avoid phishing, social engineering, so they may breach the contact. So that's why this human security is very much required. Then we are having this network security. So IP filtering, which IP packets can be transferred, which IP packets should be filtered, should be blocked, masquerading. So these are the methods with the help of which we can ensure network security. That is another kind of security, might be the OS. That means I know that we can, in case of OS, it will have a knowledge to identify the users, and it might be through some encrypted passwords. The password should be non-guessable. It might be one-time password, OTP. It might be, should be very secret password. And in this way, the OS security can also be ensured. So we are having four levels of security. One is a physical, next one is human, network, and OS. In this particular diagram, I have tried my level best to put all the aspects here. So this section is for the authentication service, and this section is for the authorization service. We shall be having the respective databases here. So authentication database, and here we'll be having the authorization database. Okay. Now this is my user kernel. You know that kernel or nucleus is the core part of the operating system. So this user kernel will take the support of this authentication system to authenticate one user. So login and authentication info will be passed, and then authentication token will be made available to the kernel. And this user kernel can also do some changes in the privileges or in the authorization parameters of a certain users. So changes in the privileges, whether he or she can read or write or execute. And this is the authorization service and the respective authorization database. And here also we'll be having this transfer of this authentication token, whatever kernel has got. So authentication token will be passed, and then this authorization service will say yes, he or she is allowed, yes, the user is not allowed. So in this way, yes or no will be coming from this, and service and resource manager will take this particular yes or no as the input and do the needful accordingly. And these are the requests and responses that will be communicating in between this user kernel and this service and resource manager. So this is the total block diagram with the help of which we have tried to explain the authentication services and the authorization services and generic security and protection setups in OS. This is the footer of this particular block diagram. In the next video, we'll be going for more details into the security measures of operating system. Thanks for watching this one.